guys, welcome back to my channel. So I'm starting off my look today by, of course, pushing my hair back out of my face. I'm going to be starting off with some eyeshadow primer. This one is my favorite from NARS. I'm just using this one to prevent my eyeshadows from creasing all day and also to make the eyeshadow stick on my eyes better. Right here I'm using MAC Painterly Paint Pot. I'm using this to cover up the veins in my eyes. I explained in my last video that I use two primers because I use one to make my eyeshadows last all day, and I use this one to prevent any sort of veins from showing through on my eyelids. I'm also doing this as a first step because when I'm going to be applying my brow products right after, they're going to stick better since there's a base already on. So right here I'm just brushing my eyebrows out with a spoolie. Now I'm using the Dip Brow Pomade from Anastasia. This product is very concentrated, so I use the tiniest amount. What I do is I use this little angled brush and I dip it in the product and I just wipe it off with Kleenex. And then I apply it directly to my eyebrows very, very sparingly. So right here I'm using this eyeshadow from Too Faced. It's basically a white matte eyeshadow. I did this in my last video as well. And I'm just carving out my eyebrows just to make them look cleaner. Right here I'm using this brow gel from Anastasia. I recently purchased the brow gel and also the dip brow, and I'm really liking both products. This one is tinted like a sort of golden color, and I just like it to set my eyebrows. So now I'm using this Naked eyeshadow from Urban Decay, and I'm just sweeping that all over my crease. The eyeshadow look I did today is extremely basic. I'm just doing a matte brown color in the crease, and I'm going to be doing a matte white on my eyelid. So here I'm using Makeup Geek Vanilla Bean, and I'm just applying that all over my eyelids just to sort of neutralize the color and just add something there. Now I'm going to start off by doing a wing with a tiny little brush that comes with the L'Oreal gel liner. I'm just starting off and I'm just extremely slow at gel liner, so you can see me doing little tiny bits and pieces right here of my gel liner, and I actually messed it up today and I start off again. It takes practice, especially in front of the camera. It's really hard to film. So right here I'm doing my wing like I explained in my previous videos, and right here I'm done. So now I'm going to be applying some false lashes. I'm using these ones from Quo, and they're extremely, well, for my standards, they're very dramatic. And I liked it for this look. I felt like it gave a lot of drama, so I'm just applying them with some tweezers. Now I'm going in with some mascara, and I'm just applying a little bit to my eyelashes because they're blonde and I just want to sort of blend them in better with the false lashes. Here I'm going over with some eyelash curlers once again just to make sure that everything is blended and everything looks natural. Well, as natural as possible, that is. Here I'm going in with a black pencil. I used to really like the one from NARS, but it's not as pigmented as this one, so I'm just using this one because it lasts really well and it gives off a lot of black, and I'm using that to tightline, as you could see. Right here I'm going in with a black liquid liner just to cover up any glue. Now I'm starting off my base for my face, and I just recently bought a tiny version of the Hourglass number 28 primer, which is a hydrating primer. And I'm trying it out, so I apply this all over my face, pretty basic. So now I'm using the Bourjois 10 Hour Sleep Foundation. Like I said in my previous videos, this is my favorite foundation ever. It's really good for dry skin, and this color matches me extremely well. So I just applied that all over my face. I just dotted it on. And I actually mixed two colors actually because I tanned a little bit because I went to Cuba recently. So I'm just patting that all over my face using this brush from Delium Tools. I really like this brush. It's my favorite brush that I found so far to blend in this foundation. And it really gives a pretty finish. What I do is I just tap it on like you can see right here. And because I have dry skin, this sort of avoids emphasizing any flaky bits on my face. Right here I'm going with some under eye concealer. I purchased this one recently as well, and this one's from CoverGirl, and the shade that I chose, I don't know if it's the color or like it was meant to be this way, but the color is a little bit peachy, which I actually really like because it kind of counteracts the blue under my eyes. So I'm just applying that and blending that with my fingers just to sort of make it easier for myself. And right here I'm just setting everything with a CoverGirl loose powder. So right here with the same powder and the same brush, I'm just going to be setting my entire face. I'm actually just going to set the center of my face. I wanted to leave this look really dewy, so I used the powder and I was very sparing, and I placed it very specifically on my nose, my forehead, and a little bit on my chin. Right here I'm using a matte sort of cream eyeshadow from NYX. I'm doing this trick that I like to do. I just apply it in the sort of crevice of my under eye bag, and what this does is sort of cancels out the darkness there and sort of evens out my under eyes. So I don't do this all the time, but I like doing it sometimes. Right here I'm using NYX Jumbo Eye Pencil in Milk. I'm using this just as a sort of base for the next color. Here I'm using this eyeshadow from Urban Decay. It's such a pretty color. It's like a vibrant, like, cobalt blue, I describe it as, and it's shimmery, and I'm just applying that over the white base. The reason I used a white is because I really wanted this color to look super bright, and so I'm really not being shy here, and I'm applying a lot under my eyes. And I'm using that with a small smudge brush just to sort of get the most intense color possible. Right here I'm using my favorite brush to blend my under eye eyeshadow out, and I'm just sweeping that under my eyes and making sure it doesn't look too harsh. Here I'm going in with another eyeshadow from Urban Decay. This is called Skimp. I'm applying this right in the inner corners of my eyes. It's a very light beige shimmery color, and I'm just using that to brighten up my eyes. Right here I'm going in with this CoverGirl mascara, the same one I used on my upper lashes, just to sort of define my lower lashes. Now I'm going in with a nude pencil. I'm doing this just to sort of separate the blue from my eyes, just to make it look a little less harsh, I guess. I was just doing that also to brighten up my eyes. Right here I'm going in with the star of the show, which is another Velvet Matte Lip Pencil. I know I used a lot of these, but I love them so much. I bought this one, like, again, recently. And I'm applying this all over my lips. It's pretty self-explanatory. It's really hard to apply this color precisely because it is so dark. And as I explained in a past video, the tip of these pencils is a little bit like blunt. So you can use a lip brush if you would like, but I was just not in the mood for that today. So I just applied it directly with from the bullet. And what I decided to do is I cleaned it up like I did in the previous video with the same powder I used on my face, which is the one from CoverGirl? No. It's just a basic, I don't remember which one it is, but it's a basic sort of face powder that has color in it. And I apply that over my around my lips just to sort of clean it up, and right here I'm blending it out. Now I'm going in with a cream blush from NYX. I think I got this in an Ipsy bag actually, and I really hated it at first, but it's actually really pretty as a sort of all over sort of dewy bronze look. And I wanted to do this because I felt like the look was really cool toned and I wanted to add a little bit of warmth. So yeah, I just applied that with a small stipple brush from e.l.f. And that's it. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Please let me know what you thought, and I'll see you soon.